Praise the Lord. Before I was coming, I was saying to myself, Father, I'm not very good at public speaking. Anytime I get a chance to speak up for myself, I get nervous and there's no confidence. So she helped me. So yes, she's helping me. Today, I want to give thanks to Jesus Almighty. This is one of the best things that I've ever. I'm so glad he saved me from the dark. Hello, Lord Jesus. I can't stop thanking you now. Help me say thank you to him. He did it. Jesus did it. Can I have my fingers in on me?
Yeah.
take this opportunity to thank Victoria Michaels for inviting me to Revelation Church. And through that, I had the opportunity and I had an encounter with God right here in this church with the help of Pastor Gabby and his beautiful wife, Aunt Kachi. May God bless you so, so much for the good things you are doing for God. For the good things you are doing for God. And I pray that I'm going to help you win more souls for Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus. Don't be surprised when you see me talking about God or preaching the word. Because that's what I've decided to do from now, forever, and ever, and ever, and ever. Daddy, Mommy, I love you both so much. I love you so much. I love you so much. And I thank God for your life. I thank you so much, Auntie, Mommy. I thank you for taking care of my father all these years. May God bless you. May God bless you so much. May God bless you. This short time that you've been around me, I realized that it wasn't easy taking care of my father. God bless you. God bless you. And Daddy, I love you so much. And I pray to God that He should heal you soon. He should heal you soon right this moment. In the mighty name of Jesus. 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 Father Lord, I'm your daughter. This is the only thing I ask for you. You've told me I've been crying over my dad for a very long time. Please, I need a miracle today. I need a miracle today. I need a miracle today. In the mighty name of Jesus. 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 Daddy. God is going to do it. He will do it soon. He will do it. Believe it and say amen. 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 Just let's all pray for my dad this moment. He wasn't born with a blindness. He wasn't born with it. He wasn't born with it. He wasn't born with a blindness. I don't know where this is coming from. But as I stand here today, I pray that wherever this blindness is coming from right this moment, I rebuke it in the mighty name of Jesus. 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 Spirit of darkness, leave this room right this moment. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Souls for Christ, and that is why the Revelation Church was born. But as I stand here this morning, I also understand prophetically that sometimes there are people that God will bring into the kingdom at a certain time. And if you look, if we look at history, prophetic history, and we see how God, you know, arrested and apprehended certain people and brought them to this way, the way Jesus Christ. See somebody like Apostle Paul, who was a murderer, for instance, and very important. And this gentleman had killed so many people. And the Bible says that one day on his way to Damascus, Jesus apprehended him. And since Jesus arrested that man began to arrest men for Jesus. And whenever I look at Mauricia and her encounter, I'm telling you, you are going to be a part of your generation because God is going to lead you. And for me, it is not even about the Revelation Church. Because when I look at her, I know that she is for the body. She's for the body of Christ. It's not about church. It's not about... God has picked her up, cleaned her up. And whether you believe it or not, what God has started in her life, He is going to complete it. Are you hearing what I'm saying today? I am standing here today as a pastor in this season because I know that God has appointed me and I know the responsibility of pastoring her in this very important season of her life. I don't take it for granted. And I want to say to you, everyone that knows her, and those that are watching now and those that will watch later, I am telling you, the Bible says for this purpose, the Son of God was made manifest for this purpose, that He might destroy the works of Satan. And I don't care what the works of Satan is, but I've seen Satan fall down like lightning. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
I thank Jesus because I know that even if this is the soul that we won during our inaugural service, it is enough. It is worth it. And can I tell you, one thing about light, light shines the brightest, where darkness is deepest. It doesn't matter how dark it is. I tell you that Mauricia, the person you used to know as Moesha, she has had an encounter with Jesus Christ. And today, I declare you a daughter of Zion.
Amen.
You will do the will of God.
Amen.
Are you hearing what I'm saying? The hand of the Lord is upon you. So, I mean, I just want to pray because I know that one of the things that is in your heart is for your dad to see. And I want you to believe God. It will be a major testimony.
Amen.
And it's going to happen. It's going to happen.
Amen.
In fact, it's going to happen. And there is no reason it will not happen today. And God will do it. Just trust the Lord. I'm telling you, we have faith in what God is about to do. And God will do it. I just want to pray for you and I want to pray for your family. One prayer. That your heaven will be open. Let there be an open heaven concerning this family. Because you, Mauricia Pidon, have found Jesus, light has come. Light has come. In the name of Jesus, let there be illumination. Let there be illumination. In the mighty name of Jesus. And not just for you, but for every testifier, everyone that's still here to testify. I pray for more open heaven in the name of Jesus. Let your heaven remain open to the glory of the name of Jesus. Father, we stand today prophetically and I stand together with all your sons and your daughters here. And we claim this one for the kingdom. We pray that as your daughter have come to you, Lord, may she never go back. In the mighty name of Jesus, use her as an oracle of your word. Let your name be glorified through her life. Lord, as the world will hear her, let life change. Let life change. Let life change. The greatest testimony is a testimony of salvation, not the testimony of stuffs. So we are grateful for what you have done in the life of your daughter and the life of all your people that testify today. We give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. In the mighty name of Jesus. And all the saints shall say loud, amen.
Amen.
Amen and amen. Amen. Praise. Praise God. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you. Can we celebrate Jesus? Can we celebrate Jesus? Amen, amen. Put your hand together for Jesus. Are you sure? It was Jesus. Come on now. Come. Let's give him praise. Let's give him praise.